From pink houses to private jets. Can I
get it? Please.
Matty Mo's art is an Instagrammer's dream. If you search for the most famous artist on Google, there among Kahlo, Picasso, and Warhol, you'll find this guy.
That's a key takeaway, is that the internet isn't real. Surprise.
The most famous artist you've never heard of.
Who's the most famous artist?
The most famous artist is an idea. Anyone that believes they're the most famous artist is the most famous artist.
That's not true.
It is.
No.
The whole idea is that you can be whatever you think you can be. And so one day, a few years ago, I decided I wanted to try to be the most famous artist, and I became it.
How did you do it?
Selfie-friendly murals and headline-worthy projects.
He's also perfected search engine optimization by giving himself the most famous artist moniker back in 2004.
What kind of ego does one have to call themselves the most famous artist?
Ironically, I'm trying to approach life with a lot less ego.
He takes us behind the scenes in his studio to reveal that the most famous artist isn't just one person.
This is Toby. She's an architecture master's.
But it's actually a kind of art collective.
Do you want to sit in the jet?
Yeah.
Let's go.
One of his collaborators is best known for creating the Hollyweed sign.
I actually thought it was a joke or a hoax or maybe a promotion for a movie. The only way I'd be able to know for sure is to come up here and see for myself.
Eventually charged for trespassing, he now has his own cannabis line.
So you've just launched this weed brand?
Yeah, Hollyweed.
In an era when social media moments dominate headlines, Matty Mo's proudly created ours.
I'm gonna try and pin you down on this though.
Okay.
Do you think you're a good artist, a great artist, or are you just an artist of deception?
Well, I don't quite know where this quote is from, but I say it all the time, which is, a good artist is someone who uses the tools of their time to tell the stories of their time and contextualizes it in art past. And so in that context, I'm a great artist. I'm using the internet, which is the tool of our time, to tell the story of selfie culture. And I'm studying past artists to understand how my work fits in. Whether or not the art market is ready for that is a different question.
Part performance artist, part businessman, Matty Mo reacts to the changing cultural landscape around all of us.
This is what I need to do? Something like this?
We followed him to the streets of Melrose, the epicenter of Instagrammable moments.
We flew 24 hours almost just to capture the famous pink wall in LA.
I'd estimate 100,000 people a year take photos in front of this pink wall.
But there's nothing special about it.
It's a pink wall.
Exactly.
But it's a pink wall that people use to construct an identity on Instagram, so there's something special about it. People are bored with their normal lives. They're looking for satisfaction in the form of likes and comments on Instagram.
He unabashedly capitalizes on a generation selfie-obsessed, at one point deciding if someone else's pink wall creates this much buzz, he'll turn an entire block pink.
Hordes of people taking selfies descended upon it, and it became a major headline around the world. And that helped me become the most famous artist.
Do you see our obsessions with selfies and creating this facade, this idealized life that we're living, instead of being in the moment? Is that a problem?
It's not a problem like world hunger. It's silly.
And in a twist, he claims his work actually fights against the most damaging part of selfie culture, the fear of missing out.
FOMO is brought about by an individual representing themselves at a time and place that is unattainable for others, and democratizing access to those types of experiences that individuals are using to create FOMO is a fun mission.
You seem like you're having a lot of fun.
Well, I'm glad you can tell too.
One of his more recent and participatory projects, making the private jet experience available to those of us who can't jump on our own plane to a private island.
I'm using it as a platform to express myself creatively, and if I happen to make a lot of money doing it, I'm not gonna be mad.
Part of maintaining most famous artist status means producing pop culture art in the moment.
The weekend that Hulu and Netflix dropped their Fire documentaries, I saw an opening, which was a news cycle about this topic. And so we created an experience in a few days that was selfie friendly, that rode the news cycle and crowds of people descended upon it. And why did they do so? Primarily because they're trying to tell a story that their life is interesting and that they were part of something.
This is Matty's world.
Can I touch some of
your
fruit?
Yeah, please do.
His next collaboration, The World of Fruit, which, like the Museum of Ice Cream, Candytopia, and The Color Factory, draws fans in for the sake of experiential photo ops.
You have the dice in there, you've got the marbles.
Not everyone is a fan of Matty Mo's approach to art. Yeah. Art dealer Stefan Simkowitz calls Matty Mo an interesting person who makes garbage art.
He reflects its tragic problems, vapidity and venality of selfie culture, the fact that the art just functions as a prop. It's almost like drinking orange juice that is yellow and sweet, but isn't made from oranges. It's just sugar and colored water made to taste with some preservatives like orange juice.
Devoid of any substance.
It's devoid of any substance. And this is a fundamental problem in culture today. So Matty Mo, this is the banality of culture as it exists today. The work is terrible.
The most famous artist doesn't fully disagree.
Well, the definition of artist by the art world is definitely not one I fit into. The art world wouldn't call me an artist because I didn't go to art school and I'm not represented by galleries and I don't show at art fairs. I'm actually using the internet and the democratic effects of software to distribute my work. I love this.
And he knows the greatest distribution of his work takes place when we pick up our phones.
This is the most analytical I think anyone has ever been about a selfie.
We're selfie scientists.
Selfie scientists? Did you just make that up right now?
I think so.
That's good.
The illusionist holding up a mirror to ourselves in a time of changing art.
Right? Nice.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.